Hello everyone, welcome to Control System Lectures. In the last video we discussed about limit cycles. In this one we will be seeing Poincare-Bendixson theorem, which is used to show the existence of limit cycles. So let's start our lecture. Poincare-Bendixson theorem is a method to establish that closed orbits exist in particular systems. So according to theorem, suppose that R is a closed bounded subset of the plane R square. So let this be R, and R usually has an annular shape like this. So this is the region R. Now this region R should satisfy certain conditions, that is, x dot equal to f of x is continuously differentiable vector field on an open set containing R, and also R should not contain any fixed points, as in equilibrium points. This is the reason why R has an annular shape, because limit cycles exist around equilibrium points. So for a limit cycle to exist in R, there should be an equilibrium point in this region. Let this point be the equilibrium point P, but we can't have the equilibrium point in region R. Hence, R is chosen in such a shape that the equilibrium point is avoided. Okay, now consider that there is a trajectory C that is confined in R. That is, C starts in R and stays in R for all future time. So this is C. If all these points are satisfied, then trajectory C is either a closed orbit or it spiral towards a closed orbit as time approaches infinity. This means that R contains a closed orbit, that is, a limit cycle exists in R, like this. So this is Poincare-Bendixson theorem. We are not discussing the proof here because it requires strong background in mathematical analysis. But I will give you an intuitive idea on why this theorem works. See this fourth point. For trajectory C to always stay in R, the vector fields at the boundaries of R should always point towards R, that is, like this. Similarly, at this boundary also, it should point towards R. Now, if we start on one of the boundaries of R, the solution will enter R since the velocity vector points into the interior of R. As the time goes on, the solution can never leave R since, as it approaches a boundary curve trying to escape R, it is forced to stay inside R as the velocity vectors are always pointing inwards. Since the solution can never leave R, the only thing it can do as t tends to infinity is either approach a critical point or spiral in towards a closed trajectory. But we have already chosen R such a way that it has no critical points within it. So the only option is to have a closed trajectory. Hence, there is a limit cycle inside R. However, Poincare-Bendixson theorem is not easy to apply practically. This is because, although it is easy to satisfy the conditions 1 to 3, condition 4 is a tough one. For this, we need to find an annulus such a way that the vector fields point into it on its boundary. Thus, like I said, Poincare-Bendixson theorem can be difficult to apply in practice. Now, let us discuss another criterion which can prove the absence of limit cycles in region R. Assume there is a closed trajectory C inside R. Let x1 dot equal to f of x1 comma x2 and x2 dot equal to f of x1 comma x2 be the system equations. Then, using Green's theorem, we can write closed integral of f1i plus f2j dot nds equal to double integral of dou f1 by dou x1 plus dou f2 by dou x2 into dx dy, where D is the region inside the closed curve C. The LHS of this equation becomes closed integral C of f1 into dx2 plus f2 into dx1 equal to double integral of dou f1 by dou x1 plus dou f2 by dou x2 into dx dy. This equation, however, is a contradiction. By hypothesis, the integrand on the right hand side is continuous and therefore can never be zero in R. Thus, it is either always positive or always negative. Therefore, RHS of this equation is either always positive or always negative. On the other hand, the left hand side of this equation must be zero. Why? Because for C to be a closed trajectory, C should be tangent to the velocity field f1i plus f2j defined by the system. This means that the normal vector n to C is always perpendicular to the velocity field f1i plus f2j. Therefore, the dot product of f1i plus f2j dot n is always zero. That is, the integrand on the left hand side of this equation is zero. This contradiction means that our assumption that R contained a closed trajectory was false. This criterion we used is called Bendixson's criterion, and it is stated as, if f1 and f2 are continuous in region R which is simply connected, and the expression dou f1 by dou x1 plus dou f2 by dou x2 is not identically zero and does not change sign at any point of R, then the system x1 dot equal to f of x1 x2 and x2 dot equal to f2 of x1 x2 has no closed trajectories inside R. Now, let's see an example to familiarize this criterion. Consider a system represented by the differential equation d square y by dt square minus of b minus 10 by 3 dy by dt square into dy by dt plus y square equal to 0. Writing down the state equations, x1 dot equal to x2 and x2 dot equal to b minus 10 by 3 x2 square into x2 minus x1 square. So let this equation be f1 of x1 comma x2 and this be f2 of x1 comma x2. Therefore, dou f1 by dou x1 will be 0 and dou f2 by dou x2 will be b minus 10 x2 square. Therefore, dou f1 by dou x1 plus dou f2 by dou x2 will be b minus 10 x2 square. If this b is less than or equal to 0, then the expression dou f1 by dou x1 plus dou f2 by dou x2 is always negative, and by Bendixson criteria, limit cycle does not exist. So let me write that down. There are two cases for this. The first one is b is always less than or equal to 0. In this case, limit cycle does not exist. So what if b greater than 0? In that case, we can't conclude whether the expression has a fixed sign. So we can't say anything regarding limit cycles in this case. That is, no conclusion can be made. Here, we have to go back to our analysis of system by linearizing it and then sketching the phase quadrates around the equilibrium points and finding out if the singularity is of vortex type. I assume that you all remember that because we have already discussed this all in detail in lecture number 5. If you have any doubt, please go back to that lecture. Now, to summarize, the Poincare-Bendixson theorem is one of the central results of nonlinear dynamics. It says that the dynamical possibilities in the phase plane are very limited. If a trajectory is confined to a closed bounded region that contains no fixed points, then the trajectory must eventually approach a closed orbit. Nothing more complicated is possible. However, this depends crucially on the two-dimensionality of the plane. In higher dimensional system, the Poincare-Bendixson theorem no longer applies. Instead, the trajectories may wander around forever in a bounded region without settling down to a fixed point or a closed orbit. In some cases, the trajectories are attracted to a complex geometrical object called a strange attractor, where the motion is aperiodic and sensitive to tiny changes in the initial conditions. This sensitivity makes the motion unpredictable in long run. This situation or phenomenon is called chaos. The famous butterfly effect we all have heard about is an example of chaos. So, Poincaré-Bendixson theorem implies that chaos can never occur in the phase plane. That's all for this lecture. As a review of what we have studied in this video, firstly we discussed about Poincaré-Bendixson theorem, followed by the Bendixson's criteria to check for the absence of limit cycle, which we also implemented in an example question. If you found the lecture useful, please like the video and also support us by subscribing to the channel. In the next video, we will discuss about feedback linearization. Thanks for watching and have a nice day.